Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath. Thanks for coming back and checking out my channel. I often get asked by many people about weight loss. How can they lose weight? What are some of the secrets of getting weight off, you know, keeping that weight off, maintaining that weight loss? Do my gut bacteria have anything to do with it? Does a microbiome, human microbiome, have any effect on a person's ability to maintain that weight, you know, especially obese people? Or can it influence a person's ability to lose weight and maintain normal weight like someone like me? Well, let's talk about that. There's a couple of studies here I'm going to run by you. These are recent studies from like last year and even this year. So lots of materials coming out all the time. And this stuff's validating the work I've been doing now for decades. I've been telling people now for 20 years plus that if they get their gut in great shape, that the weight will fall off. And it's being validated now. They're finally starting to find this out, you know, through research done in the Mayo Clinic and the University of Copenhagen, Harvard research, you know, research in England, research in Romania, research all around the world now is validating exactly the stuff that people have been saying for a long, long time. So I feel a bit vindicated, which is pretty cool. So let's talk about the Mayo 2013 study that you may be aware of. So some people may have seen this study, you know, reported about the two main groups of bacteria, the phasicolarca bacteria and dialysta bacteria. So this was quite a big study that was completed involving 26 obese adults, so very big adults, over a 90-day period. But basically what they discovered is that one group of people had a 527% greater weight loss than the other group. So one group had a massive amount of weight that they were shedding compared to the other group, who just couldn't seem to lose that kind of body size. And when they looked at it, the exercise was the same for these people over that three-month period. The diet was the same, but the difference was the gut bacteria. So the group who lost the most amount of weight, which is a whopping 17.4 pounds, had a large amount of the phasicolarca bacteria in their gut, compared to the other group who lost only 3.3 pounds, they had this bacteria called dialysta bacteria. So dialysta bacteria is a bacteria that actually gobbles up and uses the person's carbohydrate load that they're consuming. So it's actually burning up those calories of that rather than the person burning up the calories. So the food, and therefore, is not giving the person any real nourishment, giving them any energy or making them feel good. It's just basically passing straight through them, which means they'll eat more and more and more food. So foods have an ability, obviously, to pile on the weight if you eat too much of them. But bacteria, remember, can also be mouth feeders, whereas the phasicolarca bacteria are actually utilizing the food for energy and giving the person a boost physically, mentally, emotionally. They're feeling good eating this food. So now you can see how bacteria can be influenced, you know, by the food you eat. And that, in turn, if we extrapolate that, can change your body size. So even though the diet can be the same, if the bacteria are different, that weight's not going to come off. Let's go further. The University of Copenhagen study that was done in March last year was a very, very interesting one. 62 people, two groups, group A and group B. So group A were given basically a very healthy Mediterranean diet. The diet that a lot of you guys out there are probably eating now, the way I eat, you know, lean proteins, small amount of lean proteins, high quality vegetables and fruits in the diet, nuts and seeds, grains, just high quality food, which I talk about a lot on this channel. So that was group A. Group B were put on the standard Danish diet, which is similar to the standard American diet or the SAD diet. So this is high fat, high salt, high sugar, white bread, lots of margarine, deep fried foods, what I call embalmed foods, basically crap foods. So when they looked at both of these groups, group A had a weight loss of 7.7 pound. Group B had a weight loss of 3.7 pound. Now, the interesting thing here is when they examined group A, they found two types in group A. One group lost a lot of weight, you know, which is a 7.7 pound. One lost less weight, not quite the 3.7 pound, but not quite the 7.7 pound. The people who lost the most weight in that one particular, in group A, had a particular ratio of two main types of bacteria, Bacteroides and Prevotella. So this ratio was quite well defined in the person who lost the most amount of weight. And they found multiple people in group A with that correct ratio of those two bacteria lost the most amount of weight. compared to people in the same group eating the same very healthy food were losing weight, but not at the same rate as the people with that ratio. Now, this study points out that even in spite of a good diet, if the bacteria aren't really there in their place, if you haven't got good levels of bacteria, good levels of pharyngioides, good levels of bacteroidetes, good levels of pre-vitella. So we've got three big camps of bacteria in there. So if these ratios are good, that's going to favour also good ratios of other beneficial bacteria, particularly the lactobacillus, the bifidobacteria. You're going to have much higher levels of these, which means you're going to have better fermentation and better levels of long-chain fatty acids. You know, and these long-chain fatty acids, of course, when we get these good fatty acids happening in the intestine, it means that a lot of receptors are going to work a lot more effectively with hormones that are produced, which manipulate and regulate our appetite. We'll talk about a lot more about the short-chain fatty acids later on. So as you can see now, even eating a good diet is no guarantee you're going to get a lot of that weight off. The bacteria have to be in their place. The other thing I'd like to talk about is metabolic endotoxemia. This is a weird word, isn't it? When you have bacteria that die in your gut, it's a bit like a garbage heap in your gut, to be honest. Now, you've got all sorts of junk in there, but when bacteria die, they leave cell fragments behind, small, tiny little carbohydrate portions and protein portions. Little bits and pieces of cell fragments get left behind. Also from yeast, we'll leave cell fragments, almost like shards of glass, and this needs to be cleaned up. Now, with people with a leaky gut, this is not really going to happen that well. So they're going to get this stuff called lipopolysaccharide, okay, this sort of production of these polysaccharides from these cell fragments, and that causes what we call metabolic endotoxemia, which is a fancy word really for a sick gut, dysbiotic gut. Now, metabolic endotoxemia is what happens a lot with people who are overweight and obese because they make the wrong food choices, they make the wrong lifestyle choices. I'm not saying all of them, but many of them do. And this predisposes a person towards a higher production of lipopolysaccharides, which pushes the person into metabolic endotoxemia. One of my good buddies in Australia just got diagnosed recently with diabetes. Now, he's only the same age as me. Now, a guy who's 60 shouldn't get diabetes unless he's doing something horribly wrong. And in this guy's case, I think that, you know, not really happy with life at the moment, eating the wrong kind of foods, yeah, just not really happy. And that can push people into making some poor choices, which can push a person more into that metabolic endotoxemia. And along with that, we get anxiety, depression, fatigue, poor sleep, poor libido, poor everything. Everything goes south. And that's when people often head to the doctor and they get put on half a dozen drugs, which just basically puts them in a downward spiral, doesn't it? So that's what we call metabolic endotoxemia. Now, the way to avoid metabolic endotoxemia is by having a very good diet, eating good foods all the time, trying to work on relaxation and improving your lifestyle, trying to be a happier person by looking at things that create a lot of happiness in your life. And the fourth point I want to talk about is coming back to those short-chain fatty acids. There are long-chain and there are short-chain, but the short-chain in particular are very, very important to cultivate in the gut, in the small and large intestine. So healthy gut flora, when I look at stool test results, comprehensive stool test results, NO3, 3, IC3 and 4+ of the healthy bacteria, I go straight to the back page and I invariably find people have very high levels or good levels of what we call short chain fatty acids. So these are the byproducts of bacterial fermentation on good foods. So when bacteria in the gut get good foods to eat, I'm going to talk about this in a subsequent video about the prebiotic foods. When they get these nice foods to eat, they create a lot of these short-chain fatty acids. We've got isovalerate, butyrate, propionate. There are many different types. Propionate in particular is a very important one because it has a big effect on multiple hormones in the gut, like ghrelin, for example, and PPYY, protein peptide, which is a very important one there, which regulates the brain's ability. It switches it on or off for the desire for food. So when you've got good levels of propionate, it will down-regulate. You're constantly wanting to eat food all the time. They've done studies in mice, they've done studies in humans, in rats, in different animals, and they've known this now to be a fact. In 2017, a very important study was released pointing directly to propionate and various hormones that influence our mood when it comes to food. So again, once again, this proves eating healthy food, creating healthy bacteria in the gut means you're going to have a way better chance of having a good body size. So I hope that information is useful for people who are interested in maintaining good weight like me, particularly as they get older. Thanks for tuning in.